Hi guys, Chef Matthew Kennedy here with the Burnbrae Farms Culinary Series, supported by Gailey Dairy Cooperative. I'm here today with Black River Cheese, and we are going to be making a delicious recipe featuring our three-year-old cheddar. Today we're going to be making a really classic dish that's certainly very trendy right now. It's called shakshuka, hailing from the Middle East. A lot of people try to take ownership of it. I'm not going to. We're just going to make it and taste it. We'll start off with some olive oil in the pan. Because we're going to be sweating, we can start off right away. There's no need to get any kind of heat on the pan. So we're going to start off with our onions, nice and simple. Use a nice sweet onion here, but one medium onion. And then we're going to be adding in some sweet peppers. This is a shepherd pepper. They're in season right now. It's certainly very affordable. So we're going to get these guys going here. We've also got some garlic, garlic we've minced. We'll dump all that in there. And we'll get this going, get a little bit of sweating on this. Sweating is really, we're just talking about concentrating flavors. So we can help that process out a little bit by adding some seasoning right off the bat. A little salt, a little pepper. And then we'll start to add in some ground cumin. We've got some sweet paprika. Make sure you're using sweet or Spanish paprika, not spicy paprika. This is gonna change the whole dimension. And some chili powder. Okay, pretty much equal parts of all three. You can go a little bit heavier if you like to. You can also just eyeball this. Really, really straightforward. Lots of nice spices. So it's really important to add them while we're sweating our ingredients. This is gonna wake up all the spices. It's gonna bring out those essential oils. That's going to bring them back to life. That's really, really crucial. While this is doing its thing, we're going to make some pita crisps. So just using your nice thin pitas, thinner the better. We've got a little marinade here. This could be a mixture of kind of any herbs in your fridge or your garden, a little bit of garlic and oil. This particular marinade has some thyme, some rosemary, some parsley and garlic, pretty much equal portions, and then just drowned in oil. The oil is going to act as a bit of a preservative, and we're just going to spread it around kind of all over the pita. This is not a fancy procedure, so just kind of go nuts. Getting lots of nice, you know, caramelization here, lots of nice toasting in the bottom of the pan. That's good. We want to watch for color, though. We want to see nice and light, translucent, not too much in that golden brown. Once things start to get tender in that 5-6 minute range, we'll think about adding some wine. Like we've talked about before, you might have heard this. When working with alcohol, always pour from a wide mouth container. Try not to pour from the bottle. So add our vino. Wine is there to add some sweetness and some acidity. You don't need a lot of it. If you have too much, then the whole dish is going to be kind of overwhelmed by that flavor profile. So that's going to simmer there. We'll let it simmer away until it gets nice and dry. After our first pita here, we'll get a little salt and pepper. Be pretty liberal with this. A lot of this will fall off. And then we'll add our another pita. Okay, kind of like a pita and herb sandwich here. Then we'll fire around some more of this marinade and really just kind of spread it all over the place. The more you get on there, the better these are gonna taste. And you can layer this, you know, 3, 4, or 5 high. And now it's time to cut these. So we're gonna get our chef's knife and we're first gonna cut them in half. To make things easier, we're then gonna pile them on top of each other, so we're cutting a little bit less. So always try to, you know, work smarter, not harder. And then we're gonna cut our pitas into nice triangles. Make sure you cut all the way through there. And then we'll layer these back and forth. This is the fun OCD chef part where you get to kind of go one this way, one this way, one this way, and just layer back and forth. Nice and easy, and you get the idea. You can just kind of rock and roll. So that was two pitas. These will go in the oven again. Christian here is gonna hook us up with some real-time cooking in the back. Now we're gonna start adding our tomatoes. These have been gutted, so we cut them in half and scooped out the insides. I happen to skin these, or concasse. You can leave the skins on if you want to as well, but important to take those seeds out. You don't wanna have too much of those kind of getting in the way of eating. Some tomatoes here from the can. When you're buying canned tomatoes, ideally, you just want to see a bit of citric acid, maybe some salt, and your tomatoes. We're doing whole tomatoes. Whole tomatoes cook really, really nicely, as opposed to crushed or diced, because the pulpa in the center doesn't fall to the bottom, so you get a really nice, thick sauce. We're gonna use some fresh parsley and fresh basil. Most people skip fresh herbs, they go straight to the pantry, but they're really missing out on so many good areas for that little bit extra pop. We're gonna roll these herbs, okay, nice and tight, and then we'll slice them nice and thin, pretty rustic. You don't need to be crazy aggressive here with the cutting. Just keep it nice. Remember to slice through your herbs, not to kind of run through them. This will keep your herbs vibrant, bright, and green. Okay, we got a nice little bundle here. We're gonna slice all of that beautiful basil. Again, you don't need to be, you know, super detailed here. Just get it nice and thin, nice and rustic. So after this simmers for a little longer, we're gonna end up with something that looks very much like this bad boy here. Kind of TV magic. And this, like I said, reduced. Do you see the thickness in this? Really luxurious thick sauce. And then we're gonna add in a nice amount of the fresh herbs. So we're gonna use a little spoon here. We're gonna get our tomato and pepper base in here and just kind of fill right to that line. And then we're gonna push all that sauce right up around the edge and create a little bit of a well for ourselves. And then we're gonna take an egg and we're gonna crack this in here, ideally no shells. We're now gonna finish off with our cheddar. Kind of go nuts, like just get as much cheddar on there as you feel is necessary. And then we're gonna hand these off to Christian. He's gonna work some magic in the back in the oven. So our eggs have been in the oven now for about 8 to 10 minutes. Again, we're just looking for that yolk to be just nicely set. Best trick to figure that out is kind of get a spoon in on the white side. If the whites are mostly cooked, pull them out, let them rest for a minute or two, and that yolk will be nice and runny. If you're a well-done fan, just leave them in there for a couple more minutes. We've also got some killer pita crisps. Gorgeous, thank you, Christian. So as you can see here, the pita crisps have just a nice golden brown on them. Nice and simple. Keep in that oven, again, at that 375, 400 degrees. If you go too hot, then you say goodbye to the pita crisps. And these work as a great little vessel for scooping out all that tomato. Beautiful. Thank you. Okay. Look at these. I mean, nicely golden brown. That cheddar just looks fantastic. Again, we're just going to have a little peek inside here just to see kind of what's going on, break into there. And we can see the white is just kind of cooking around the outside, so they look fantastic. Let these rest for just a moment. We're just gonna grab these, and presentation is certainly a must these days, so we'll get these up on our board with the side plate. Now we're gonna get some fresh parsley and just kind of have some fun with it. If some falls on the wooden board, that is okay. Some beautiful fresh basil as well. Beautiful, it smells great, and when kind of people get in there and start to eat, they're gonna love that. And you could, you could shove a couple in the side. No one likes a soggy pita. We could also put a couple just on the side there, and then people can kind of opt in or opt out. Now, of course, the moment everyone's been waiting for, mostly myself, is trying this. Man, that's good. I think I might go for a second bite. Just get right in there on that yolk. You can see the yolk there is just coming alive. And there we have it, a absolutely killer shakshuka topped with our aged 3-year-old cheddar, Black River cheese. I'm Chef Matthew Kennedy. Thank you for joining us at the Burnbrae Farms culinary series supported by Gailey Dairy Cooperative.